So let me tell you a little secret about me. My money doesn't fold. It jiggle jiggles. And if you're like me on a Top Ramen is the bomb, by the way, budget, but you still want to fly FPV, can you even get away with that in 2022? Well, today, I'm here to make it rain. Hey everybody, I'm Bacon Ninja, and today we're going to talk about budget drones in 2022, which seems like an impossible thing because the prices have just gotten ridiculous in the past couple of years. Now, when I got into FPV, albeit that was about 16 months ago, the prices were high, but they weren't as high as they are now. ESCs and flight controllers are just at insane levels. I first started out on the Rotor Riot CL1 budget kit, the DIY kit. Super basic, super cheap. It's actually still on the wall back there, and I fly it occasionally. But you could pick one of those things up for $200. It had all the carbon, it had all the electronics, the motors, everything you needed, battery pads, all the screws, every possible thing you could need to get in the air that was part of the drone was in a box for $200. You can't do that today. That's just not a possibility. Now, you can buy some cheap drones. I'll get that. There are things out there like the Eachine Wizard that you can pick up for around $200, maybe a little bit over, and then you gotta pay shipping from China, and then you're still flying an Eachine Wizard, which has the individual ESCs and the potential for failure, and not very quality components. And most of that stuff is outdated, in fact, that's on those quads. So if you're on a budget like me, if you're rocking the Maruchan, this isn't even Maruchan, this is Nissan. Maruchan is better, and I've got the Nissan brand. That's how bad it is for me. If you're rocking that stuff, what are you flying in 2022? Well, I am lucky enough to be flying this thing, which is not Top Ramen prices. This is about a $500 quad. This is my Mark V Perfect Freestyle build for 2022. It is the Mark V Pro frame, Zing 2208 motors, a SpeedyBee F7 V3 stack, the Runcam Micro V2 for HD0, the HD0 1-watt VTX, and an Axie antenna with ELRS. Really, really premium, top quality parts in this quad. It's about everything you could want as far as a non-budget drone goes in 2022. But if I want to get back to my roots, it's going to look like this. This is my 2022-2023 budget build. This is the best budget build that I could come up with for under $250. That's right, this quad here is under $250. It has Zing 2207 motors, it has the TBS Source One frame, it has a SpeedyBee F405 V3 stack, it has a Runcam Phoenix in it, and it has a SpeedyBee VTX. It's not just a basic quad. This is no Eachine Wizard, but this is Eachine Wizard prices. And what does that mean? Does that mean it flies like crap? Maybe. Does it fly like a brick of Top Ramen? Maybe it does, but also maybe it doesn't. So right now, what I'm gonna show you is a 3-minute, yes, I know it's long, but it's there to give you enough opportunity, edit where I flew both of these quads. I flew both of these things. And the only indication you're gonna get of which quad is which is an A and a B. And I'm not gonna tell you which one it is. So there, you can have fun trying to figure it out on your own. Watch my flight, dissect it, pick it apart, and decide which quad is the $500 Mark V Perfect Freestyle build, and which one is the $250 budget 2022 build, just from the flight footage. And just to make this even more complicated, I am running the exact same color props on the front, so you can't easily tell what's what. I'm also running the exact same HD camera on top of these things, so again, you can't tell what's what. And I'm using the same color grade in nearly the same lighting conditions at the same place. So yeah, just nitpick this down to what you think is what. Is quad A the cheap quad or quad B the cheap quad? Here it is, you tell me. Like no other, heartbeat racing, I'ma put you through.
keep you craving. Baby, I'ma keep you craving.
Could you tell? Could you tell which one is which? Do you have a clear indication of which one the cheaper one is? Which one is analog? Which one is digital? Which one has really nice 2208s and which one has just meh nice 2207s? Could you? It's really not that easy to tell. Now maybe you're out there really nitpicking and you saw some things that really gave it away for you. Well, that's probably because I haven't actually got finished tuning the budget build. So the Mark V is just a little bit better tuned, but if you didn't notice, if it wasn't immediately obvious to you, then why do we spend so much money on a $500 quad when we could be buying a $250 beater that if we lost it, we wouldn't cry? I mean, this quad, the camera cost about as much as the entire quad, the Hero 10 Bones that I run. This quad, the camera literally costs twice as much as this drone does. If I lost this drone in a tree, I'd want the camera back. But the rest of it, if I had to live without it, I wouldn't cry too hard. Maybe you just want a basher. Maybe you want to get into FPV and you don't want to spend a ton of money. It is possible. Now you'll notice I haven't told you which one was which yet because I'm really making you hang in there. But the cheap one was Quad A. So if you thought Quad A flew like crap, then maybe a cheap quad isn't for you. Quad B was the expensive quad. I actually flew that flight a couple days ago. Quad A was the one I flew over the weekend. You saw a cool hot air balloon in there. I think that was a little bit of fun. But you're probably wondering, where's the parts list? How do I build this thing? What is going on here? Well, that's coming because this is just the beginning of an entire series focused around this budget build. I was watching Joshua Bardwell's live stream and he said, could you build a drone for less than $250 in 2022? And he said you could. And it got me thinking, yeah, I definitely know you can, but what does that mean? What are you giving up? How do you even do it? Where are the plans for this drone? Well, that's what this series is going to be. I hand selected all the parts in this build here. I'm going to tune it. I'm going to provide the CLI dump. I'm going to show you how to build it. We're going to talk about it extensively. This is just the first video in the series. So if you don't want to miss any content about this budget build, go ahead and subscribe to the channel so that you get notified whenever I put out more about this, because I will have step-by-step building tutorials, We will go into a full deep dive on this thing about the black box analysis and all the concessions that I feel as a pilot after flying both of these things. But if you're interested in the parts list, I'm going to go ahead and give that to you now in detail. I'm just going to cover what I selected and why for this build. Because I feel like you could go ahead and start looking at the parts. And over the next few weeks, as I make these videos, feel free to follow along, build the thing, ask me questions. I'll provide all of the tuning that I do throughout the process. So you don't have to do all the difficult stuff outside of soldering and actually flying an FPV drone, because it's not that easy in the first place. So to get started, this is all built around the TBS Source One V5 frame. And yes, it's a concession for price, because the arms aren't very wide and they aren't super thick. They are 6 millimeters, which is thicker than some arms on the market, but the width means that you may break an arm occasionally here. The great thing about this frame though is that it's a split deck design, similar to what you see in the Apex, and in fact similar to what I have in my perfect freestyle build, the Mark V. The bad thing about this frame as far as building goes is that it is very narrow. It's hard to get everything in here, but I've managed to do it, and I will absolutely show you how I managed to do that when we get around to the video where I'm putting electronics in it. And speaking of electronics, I'm going with the SpeedyBee F405 V3 Stack, which if you're not familiar with that stack, I did a whole video comparing it to the T-Motor stack in the same budget range. And the reason for that video was because I planned on selecting it for this build, and it is what's in here. Now, it's not a BL-Heli 32 ESC. It's an 8-bit BL-Heli SESC. I am running Blue Jay on it, but again, we'll get to all that whenever I show you the build specifics of this quad. As far as the video system, it is analog, has the SpeedyBee 800 milliwatt TX800 VTX in it, and a Runcam Phoenix 2 in the front. The Phoenix 2 is a little bit of a concession because I really wanted the Foxeer Micro Razor, but it's out of stock everywhere all the time in 4.3, and I hate 16.9. So I threw a Phoenix 2, spent a couple more dollars, and it works out really well. I actually really enjoy that camera. For the antenna for the video system, I'm running a Foxeer Lollipop V4. It's a really nice antenna, actually, for analog. Nothing wrong with that at all. And for motors, we've got the Zing ePro 2207 1800 KV. Well, that's essentially the entire build list. If you're interested in a budget build like this, definitely keep an eye on this series. Let me know in the comments below why you're interested. Maybe you want a basher, maybe you want something to learn on that you don't care about breaking. Maybe you want to build two for the price of just this one, so that when you break one, you just have a backup quad. Maybe you want parts availability. There's a lot of reasons to want a budget build in 2022, even when you could be flying something like an Apex or a Mark V that costs twice as much. Or maybe you have digital quads and you just want something analog to beat around. Or maybe you know somebody who's getting in the hobby and you want to build them something nice for Christmas. It's time for that. But speaking of gifts, that is one of the best parts of this entire series. I have built this drone. Obviously, it is in my hand. It is a tangible object. It is already completed. However, I'm going to build another one. It's going to be the one that I use to help you follow along with the build. And then I'm going to give it away for Christmas. How does that sound? There's going to be a video somewhere in this series denoting the beginning of a giveaway. It will coincide with my 2,000 subscriber mark on the channel. Thank you very much, subscribers. I appreciate all almost 2,000 of you that are out there. And it will also be around Christmas time. So this will be a Christmas present to somebody out there. I hope it makes it a little bit more special to them. But that video will be coming soon, along with all the other videos. I really just got excited about this and wanted to go ahead and show you some comparisons between a really nice quad and a really budget quad, and let you decide just based solely on the footage, no black box analysis, nothing else about it, parts list, nothing. Which one do you think flew better? Leave me a comment below and let me know what you thought of the footage comparison. Let me know the things you noticed between them that may have been a giveaway or may not have been a giveaway. You might have actually thought Quad B was the cheap one. I don't know. Let me know in the comments. Let's talk about it. And if you want to talk about it in more detail, head over to my Discord. There is a link in the description. Definitely going to have a lot of question and answer in there about the budget build, the tuning, anything you need in there. I will be more than happy to help you out. So that's all I have. I just got excited about this and wanted to show it to you, and I hope that you will enjoy the series. I hope you enjoyed the footage. I hope you were a little surprised by what you saw in that. And until next time, stay greasy, and I'll catch you later.
Hey, how you got that money?
I went to work.
Hello?
I went to work.
Is it real?
It is real money. Huh. So what happens when you go to work, boy?
Yeah.
You make 11 bucks.
In one suit.
Yeah. 11 bucks.
Yeah.